What you should know about disproportionality in child welfare as a mandated or permissive reporter. Child abuse and neglect exist in every racial and ethnic group, every culture, every economic class, in every cross-section of our society. Abused and neglected children often rely upon a caring adult to speak up on their behalf to stop the abuse. You may be a vulnerable child's first defense against ongoing victimization. As a reporter, it is important for you to know the truth about disproportionality in the child welfare system. Disproportionality is the over or under representation of a certain group of people. In child welfare, it means that the percentage of children belonging to a certain group of people is higher or lower in the child welfare system than it is in the general population. Did you know that in our state and across the nation, children of color are overrepresented in the child welfare system at alarming rates? African American children make up 13% of the child population in Pennsylvania, but represent over 40% of the children in care. Nationally, African American children are almost twice as likely to be the subjects of abuse allegations as are Caucasian children. And once a call comes in about an African American child, it is more likely to be substantiated, and that child is more likely to be removed from the home and stay away from home longer than a Caucasian child. For American Indian children, the national rate is almost three times as many allegations of abuse or neglect than Caucasian children, and the likelihood that they will go home or be adopted is much less than Caucasian children. In Pennsylvania, Latino children are overrepresented, while Asian and Pacific Islander children are underrepresented. Both the over and underrepresentation of children reported to the child welfare system can be a disservice to those children and their families. As we know, child abuse and neglect exist in every racial and ethnic group, every culture, every economic class, in every cross-section of our society. So why are certain groups overrepresented while others are underrepresented? Did you know that families of color are more likely to interact with mandated reporters? Mandated reporters are those individuals required by law to report suspected child abuse. They are people who are likely to have direct contact with children as a result of their job or volunteer activities. People such as doctors, police officers, social workers, child care providers, and teachers are mandated reporters in Pennsylvania. If you are not a mandated reporter, you are a permissive reporter, which means you are encouraged to make a report when you have reasonable cause to suspect a child is a victim of abuse. When a family is more likely to come into contact with a mandated reporter, they are more likely to be exposed to and scrutinized by people outside their family and community. This exposure opens them to the biases of others. Likewise, children belonging to groups that society stereotypes in a positive light, like Caucasian Americans or wealthy families, may not come in contact with as many mandated reporters, or may not receive the same scrutiny. If abuse exists in these homes, it may go unreported, and those families may not receive the services they need. It is absolutely critical that as a professional interacting with children on a regular basis, to be aware of and manage cultural biases based on race, income, ethnicity, and sexual orientation. Check yourself. Ask yourself, have I always reported my concerns of abuse or neglect when I believe that a child was in danger? It is vital that you do not hesitate to report if you truly believe any child is in harm's way due to abuse or neglect. Check yourself. Ask yourself this question. All things being equal, would I make the same call in the same way if I saw the exact same things happening in a Caucasian family? Often, cultural differences equate to parenting differences. One culture may speak to their children in a manner that seems louder or harsher than a reporter is familiar with, or parents may seem uninvolved or standoffish. Cultural differences in parenting may not constitute abuse or neglect. Check yourself. We all harbor personal biases, whether we like it or not. We cannot grow up in the United States without being bombarded with images and messages that are driven by racism, prejudice, or racial privilege that we may not even be aware of. Think about the messages that have infiltrated your belief system. Be honest with yourself. Do you believe, even just a little bit, that some people actively seek government handouts rather than jobs? Do you believe that most Latino people are in this country illegally? Do you buy into the notion that African American men are more likely to be aggressive or that Asian women are passive? Do you worry that people who have immigrated to this country are somehow a threat to your personal prosperity or security? Do you question the morality of people based on their religion or sexual orientation? How do these beliefs influence your assumptions about their ability to parent? These questions are not intended to blame. They are meant to get us all thinking about how those beliefs and stereotypes we may not even realize are there influence our thoughts and actions as reporters. Check yourself. Take a moment to do a little internal self-assessment. On a scale of 1 through 10, how culturally competent would you say you are? Do you think those around you would agree? Are you aware of and actively managing the cultural biases you have? How important is it to you to invest the time and energy to improving your level of cultural awareness, sensitivity, and competency? Could you do more? Are you willing to learn more? Never second-guess yourself if you have reason to believe that a child has been abused or neglected. However, if there is a question in your mind and the family involved happens to be a family of color, check yourself. You are either a mandated or a permissive reporter. You make a difference in the lives of vulnerable children. Child welfare professionals can't do the work we do without you. We thank you for your dedication to safety and quality of life for all children. Check yourself. If you believe any child is the victim of abuse or neglect, report it. It's the law. For more information about racial disproportionality and disparity in the child welfare system, go to www.ppcwg.org and click the Disparity and Disproportionality tab. The online training, Recognizing and Reporting Child Abuse, will help you determine if you are a mandated or permissive reporter in Pennsylvania and what your rights and responsibility are as a reporter. Detailed instructions for making a report are included in this training. For general information about child welfare, foster parenting, and adoption, visit www.pacwrc.pitt.edu or www.dpw.state.pa.us. We would like to acknowledge the Washington State Department of Social and Health Services, DSHS, for their model, Racial Disproportionality in the Child Welfare System, and for consultation from and collaboration with the DSHS Children's Administration, Office of Visual Communications, and Office of Diversity and Inclusion. Remember, you could be the one person to stop a child's suffering. Take the time to learn more, to get involved, to report suspected child abuse and neglect.